Look around you. Our planet is bursting with life. But have you ever wondered where it all began? Scientists believe every living thing on Earth can be traced back to a single ancestor. It's LUCA. LUCA stands for the last Universal Common Ancestor. Imagine a tiny basic organism, a single cell living billions of years ago. This little life form, LUCA, is the forefather of everything that lives and breathes on Earth today. Through genetic analysis and studying the fossil record, we're slowly piecing together the story of LUCA and the origins of life on Earth. For a long time, scientists believed that LUCA emerged around 4 billion years ago, but recent research suggests LUCA might be even older. Published in the journal Nature Ecology and Evolution, this research indicates LUCA could have been around just 400 million years after Earth's formation. This means LUCA lived during the Hadean Eon, a time of intense heat and pressure, an environment that seems utterly inhospitable to life as we know it. Yet incredibly, LUCA not only survived, it thrived. It's a testament to the resilience and adaptability of life. Imagine trying to trace your family tree back millions of years. That's what scientists are doing when they study LUCA. They're analyzing the very building blocks of life itself, genes. Every living thing possesses a genetic code written in the language of DNA. By comparing the genetic codes of different species, scientists can estimate how closely related they are and how long ago they shared a common ancestor. By tracing these genetic lineages back through time, scientists can get closer to the root of the tree of life, where LUCA resides. By analyzing the genes of thousands of organisms, scientists are building a clearer picture of LUCA and its place in the grand scheme of life. The next step is to understand the world in which LUCA lived, a world vastly different from our own. It's a complex and painstaking process, but it's yielding incredible insights into our deepest evolutionary history. Scientists use a fascinating tool in their quest to understand LUCA, a genetic time machine. By analyzing the rate at which genetic mutations occur, scientists can estimate how long ago two species shared a common ancestor. In the case of LUCA, scientists compare the genes of thousands of living organisms, looking for commonalities and differences. Despite challenges, scientists have made remarkable progress in tracing LUCA's lineage and understanding the conditions under which it lived. Imagine a world shrouded in darkness, the air thick with noxious gases, and the ground a scorching molten sea. This was the Hadean Eon. It's hard to imagine anything surviving in such a hostile environment, yet this is where LUCA, our earliest ancestor, emerged and thrived. Scientists believe that LUCA may have thrived in environments somewhat shielded from the harshest conditions, such as deep-sea hydrothermal vents or underground environments. These habitats provided the necessary chemicals and energy sources for life to emerge and evolve. LUCA, despite its simplicity, was a survivor. Scientists believe it was a prokaryote, a single-celled organism without a complex nucleus. To withstand the harsh conditions, scientists believe that LUCA likely had a primitive immune system. This resilience and adaptability are key to understanding how life not only endured, but ultimately flourished on early Earth. LUCA's story is proof of the power of evolution and the incredible tenacity of life itself. LUCA wasn't a loner. Scientists believe that even in those early harsh environments, life probably existed in communities. These early ecosystems were likely powered by chemicals, not sunlight like many ecosystems today. LUCA, in this bustling microbial city, would have interacted with other life forms, exchanging nutrients and possibly even genetic information. LUCA's story isn't just about a single organism. It's about the dawn of a planetary community, an interconnected web of life. So we know that LUCA existed, but there's still so much we don't know. The big question is, where did LUCA come from? Was it a chance event, a lucky strike in the chaos of the Hadean Eon? Or were there specific conditions that sparked the flame of life? Some researchers are recreating the conditions of early Earth in laboratories, trying to coax life into existence from non-living matter. LUCA's story is far from over. It's a mystery that continues to unfold as we delve deeper into the origins of life itself. It's astonishing to think that every living thing we see around us can trace their ancestry back to a single-celled organism that lived billions of years ago. LUCA, the last universal common ancestor, is like a distant relative we never knew we had. We often focus on the differences between species, but LUCA reminds us that beneath the surface, we're all connected. LUCA's legacy is written in every cell of our bodies, a reminder that we're part of something much larger than ourselves. So, how do we know about LUCA if it lived billions of years ago? The answer lies in the language of life itself, DNA. By comparing the DNA sequences of different organisms, we can trace their evolutionary relationships and build a family tree of life. By analyzing the DNA of thousands of species, scientists have been able to trace the branches of the tree of life back to its root, where LUCA resides. LUCA's story is just one chapter in the epic saga of life on Earth, and the language of DNA holds the key to unlocking countless more mysteries. It's hard to believe that something as complex and diverse as life on Earth could have arisen from a single simple ancestor. Over billions of years, through the processes of mutation and natural selection, LUCA's descendants diversified and evolved, giving rise to an astonishing array of life forms. From the simplest bacteria to the largest whales, every living thing is an example of the power of evolution to create complexity from simplicity. LUCA's story is a reminder that even the smallest of beginnings can have the most extraordinary consequences. The search for life beyond LUCA. LUCA's story is confined to our planet, but the search for life's origins extends far beyond Earth. Are we alone in the universe? Did life arise only once, or is it common throughout the cosmos? Thousands of exoplanets fuel our search for extraterrestrial life. Some are in the habitable zone where liquid water might exist. The possibilities are tantalizing. Could there be other LUCAs out there? Could we find ecosystems radically different from our own? The search for extraterrestrial life challenges our assumptions. LUCA's story reminds us of life's incredible ability to adapt and evolve. The universe is vast and mysterious, with the thrilling prospect of other life forms. Molecular detectives unraveling LUCA's secrets. Now, you might be wondering, how on earth can scientists possibly know anything about an organism that lived billions of years ago? It's not like we have LUCA fossils just lying around. Well, this is where things get really clever. Scientists have become molecular detectives, using the genetic information locked inside every living thing to piece together the puzzle of LUCA's existence. You see, DNA is like a history book, carrying the story of life from one generation to the next. And just like historians study ancient texts to understand the past, scientists can analyze the DNA of different species to uncover their evolutionary relationships. They've developed these incredible techniques to compare the genes of various organisms, looking for similarities and differences. It's like comparing the handwriting styles of different people to see if they're related. Now imagine doing this for thousands of species, bacteria, plants, animals, fungi, the lot. It's a massive undertaking, but the results are astounding. By analyzing these vast amounts of genetic data, scientists can build what's called a phylogenetic tree, essentially a family tree of life. This tree shows how different organisms are related to each other and how long ago they shared a common ancestor. And guess what? All the branches, no matter how diverse, ultimately converge at a single point, LUCA. The great genetic convergence, tracing the lines back to LUCA. Think of it like this. Imagine tracing your family tree back through countless generations. You'd find connections to aunts, uncles, cousins, grandparents you never even knew you had. And as you go further back in time, the branches of your family tree would converge, leading to your great-great-great and so on grandparents. That's essentially what scientists are doing with the tree of life, but on a much grander scale. By analyzing the genetic similarities and differences between species, they're tracing the lineages back through time. uncovering the branches and connections that ultimately lead to that single common ancestor, LUCA. It's a bit like solving a giant jigsaw puzzle, with each piece of genetic information revealing another clue about the evolutionary history of life on Earth. And the amazing thing is, no matter which genes scientists analyze, no matter what corner of the living world they explore, all signs point back to LUCA. This genetic convergence is incredibly powerful evidence for the existence of a last universal common ancestor. It tells us that despite the incredible diversity of life on Earth today, we're all connected, all part of one big sprawling family. Beyond LUCA, the quest for the first spark. Now, discovering LUCA is a monumental achievement, but it also raises even bigger questions. Where did LUCA come from? How did that first self-replicating, life-giving entity arise from the primordial soup of early Earth? That, my friends, is the ultimate mystery, the quest for the very spark of life itself. Scientists are exploring a number of fascinating hypotheses. Some believe that life arose in volcanic vents, those underwater chimneys spewing hot, mineral-rich water from the Earth's interior. Others propose that life emerged in shallow pools of water bombarded by ultraviolet radiation from the sun. Still others suggest that life's building blocks arrived on Earth from outer space, carried on meteorites. It's like trying to solve a cosmic crime scene, searching for clues billions of years old. And while we don't have all the answers yet, the search itself is incredibly exciting. Scientists are recreating the conditions of early Earth in laboratories, experimenting with different combinations of chemicals and energy sources to see if they can spark life anew. It's a long shot for sure, but the implications are mind-boggling. If we can crack the code of life's origins, it would not only revolutionize our understanding of our place in the universe, but also open up incredible possibilities for the future of biotechnology and even the search for life beyond Earth. The majesty of the Tree of Life. The discovery of LUCA allows us to envision life on Earth in a whole new way. Imagine a vast and intricate tree, its roots stretching back billions of years to that single common ancestor. This is the Tree of Life, a visual representation of the interconnectedness of all living things. Each branch on this tree represents a different lineage, a unique journey through evolutionary time. As we trace these branches back towards the roots, we encounter the common ancestors we share with all other life forms. Yes, you and that oak tree in your garden, that robin singing on a branch, even the microscopic bacteria teeming within the soil, all share a common ancestor somewhere on this magnificent tree. It's a humbling thought, isn't it? We often focus on the differences between species, the things that separate us. But the Tree of Life reminds us of our shared heritage. A reminder that we are all part of something much grander and more ancient than ourselves. The Tree of Life is constantly growing and changing, new branches sprouting as species evolve and diversify. Sadly, some branches cease to grow, representing the extinction of species. It's a powerful reminder of the dynamism of life, the constant interplay between continuity and change. It's a reflection of the resilience of life, its ability to adapt and thrive in the face of environmental challenges, and its endless capacity for innovation. We are all connected, embracing our shared heritage. LUCA shows we are all related, part of one big interconnected family. This challenges us to rethink our relationship with other species. They are our distant cousins, sharing a common history. Embracing our shared heritage means preserving biodiversity. Every species plays a role in the intricate web of life. Losing a species is losing a unique branch on the Tree of Life. It's a loss for both the natural world and humanity. Understanding our connection fosters wonder and responsibility. We are all part of the same extraordinary story, starting with LUCA. A legacy of life. The story of LUCA is a story of us. It's a journey that began billions of years ago with a single simple organism. From the fiery chaos of the Hadean Aeon to today's biodiversity, life has shown remarkable resilience. LUCA's legacy is in every cell, every leaf, every creature. Despite our differences, we are all connected, part of one vast family tree. LUCA's story challenges us to appreciate the interconnectedness of all living things.